Hi students, welcome to Sakshi FIIT NEET Academy. In this video session, we are going to learn about what is cation, what is anion, and what is free radical. We know in our chemistry, we observe while writing a reaction that is a positive fragment, negative fragment, as well with a free radical, that is with a one unpaired electron, with a one unpaired electron. So here, what is positive fragment, what is negative fragment, as well what is free radical fragment. So how we are getting a positive fragment, how we are getting a negative fragment, how we are getting a free radical, and why they are getting a positive charge, negative charge as well, that is a single radical. So here in this session we are going to learn about these positive fragment, negative fragment, free radical, also known as cation, anion, as well free radical. So let's begin. So these are classified as chemical species. These are also known as chemical species. Here I am taking a cation. Now anion, coming to free radical. Simple here, the suffix which is exist as ion. So what is mean by ion? Nothing but which are charged. So here the element or group of elements which having a positive charge or negative charge called a ion. So what is cation, what is anion? Simple here, assume this is a element which having a positive charge, or group of elements which having a positive charge called cation. Now coming to anion, assume this is a element which is a negative charge or group of elements which having a negative charge, called anion. So coming to free radical, there is no positive charge, no negative charge, these are neutral with a odd number of electrons. So out of all electrons, that is a odd number of electrons, one electron is unpaired, that we are mentioned here, that we are mentioning on this element. Now element or group of elements which having a neutral charge with a odd number of electrons called free radicals. So simply here, what is cation? Which is positively charged. Now coming to anion, which is negatively charged. Now coming to the free radical, neutral fragments or neutral species which having odd number of electrons called free radicals. So here I am taking an example to understand clearly what is cation, what is anion, and what is a free radical. Simple. Here I am taking a lithium which is at a neutral state. What is the atomic number of lithium? It's a 3 atomic number. 3 atomic number means here we have a 3 protons. So here proton number called atomic number. It's a neutral atom. So every neutral atom or neutral fragment shows equal number of protons and equal number of electrons. Why? Because protons means positively charged, electrons means negatively charged. When the element having a same protons, that means example 10 protons are there, so 10 protons in the nucleus and 10 electrons are revolving around the nucleus, so 10 protons, 10 electrons, the charge become neutral. Then the element doesn't get any charge. If the proton number is excess, then proton charge is positive, so number of excess protons become number of positive charge. That means the oxidation state, the positive charge means number of excess protons. Example here, electron excess is there, then number of electrons are more than -1, -2, -3. If one electron is excess compared to protons, then -1. Two electrons are excess compared to protons, -2. Same way, one proton is excess compared to electrons, +1. Two protons are excess compared to electrons, +2. That's clear. So what is cation? Simple. proton excess fragment, proton excess fragment called a cation. So example here, this lithium having a 3 protons, so neutral means 3 electrons, 3 electrons. So here neutrons also exist in a nucleus, those are mass particles, they don't have any charge, they don't have any charge. So to avoid confusion, here I am not taking a neutral, that is a neutrons, here I am taking a charged particles which are protons and electrons, protons which have positively charged, electrons which have negatively charged. So lithium, which is a neutral having a 3 protons, 3 electrons, when I am removing a 1 electron from that lithium atom, when I am removing a 1 electron from that lithium atom, so what about the lithium? Gets plus 1 oxidation state, or we can mention simple plus, because here 1 electron is lost. So here the protons are as usual, 3 protons are there, but here we have a 2 electrons, here we have 2 electrons. So 3 protons, 2 electrons means 1 proton is excess, that excess proton we are showing as a charge. Proton means positive charge, so we are showing a positive charge. These are called cations, these are called cations. So I hope you understand what is cation. Simple, the fragment which have a excess of protons, excess of protons. Example here, that neutral sodium which on loss of 1 electron converts into Na plus, because these are first group elements having a 1 valence electron and shows more electropositivity, they are ready to lose 1 electron, ready to lose 1 electron, become positive. Example here, potassium, which is neutral potassium, on loss of 1 electron converts into K plus. This is also known as oxidation, this is also known as oxidation. Here group 2 elements, which is magnesium, on loss of 2 electrons, on loss of 2 electrons get converted into Mg plus 2, Mg plus 2. Here I am taking a ferrous, on loss of 2 electrons, the ferrous get converted into Fe plus 2. Here zinc, on loss of 2 electrons, get converted into Zn plus 2, Zn plus 2. So here on loss of electron, the fragment gets a corresponding positive charge. Example, 1 electron is losing plus 1 charge, 2 electrons are going to lose plus 2 charge, 3 electrons are going to lose plus 3 charge. Simple, the protons are getting excess, so number of protons excess become positive charge. Okay, that is become a positive charge. Here we are mentioned as a positive charge. So these are called cations, these are called cations. So now coming to anion, I think already you got idea about anion. So what is anion? Here plus charge is excess, that means protons are excess. Here negative charge is excess, that means electrons are excess. Example here I am taking a chlorine, neutral chlorine having a 7 valence electrons, that means total electrons are 17, protons also 17, 17 protons are 17 electrons, 17 protons. So here atomic number means number of protons, 17 protons, 17 electrons. So to this we are adding one electron, addition of electron, also known as reduction, also known as reduction. So on reduction, the chlorine getting Cl minus, Cl minus. See, after addition of electron, the Cl minus having a 17 protons and 18 electrons, and 18 electrons. So 17 protons, 17 electrons, neutral. Here we have a one excess of electron, one excess of electron, that we are mentioned as a charge. So this is called anion, this is called anion. Same way, when you have a hydrogen which is a neutral, we are adding a one electron, on reduction hydrogen become H minus. So when we are taking a oxygen, when we are adding a two electrons, it's become O minus 2. What about OH? Shows minus 1 oxidation state. What about NH2? Shows minus 1 oxidation state. Polyatomic ion, that is SO4 minus 2, SO4 minus 2. See here, what about why, how we got this minus 2 charge? So to get this minus 2, we need to know about valence electrons of sulfur and valence electrons of oxygen. Oxygen shows minus 2 charge, so total minus 8, because of having a 4 oxygens, each oxygen exhibit minus 2, 4 oxygens means minus 8. Sulfur can donate 6 electrons, that means a plus 6, plus 6 minus 8 become minus 2. So This is a way to calculate a oxidation state on polyatomic molecule. That means a group. So to understand this, we have another video, that is a redox reactions. So in that, it will be clear. And while discussing other oxidation reduction reactions also, it become clear. So these are called anions. These are called anion. Anion means simple. On gain of electron, the fragment gets converted into negative charge. On loss of electron, that is neutral atom converts into positive charge. On gain of electron, neutral atom converts into negative charge. Negative charge means excess of electrons. Number of excess electrons, that is number of negative charges. Number of excess protons, number of positive charges. These are called cation, these are called anions. Now coming to free radical. Free radical means no oxidation, no reduction. That means no loss of electron, no gain of electron. Simply they have their own electron, which are odd numbered. Example here, hydrogen is there. Hydrogen having only one electron, so it's a radical. Example here, chlorine. So 3R pairs all get pair, and we have one unpair. So this one pair we are mentioned. So instead writing all lone pairs, here we are writing only Cl radical. Cl radical. In same way, here we have a Br radical, bromine radical, and you can write a iodine radical, and you can write a CH3 radical. See, around this carbon we have a 3 bond pairs, 6 including this electron, 7 electrons. This is become free radical. Now what about here, OH radical? So oxygen shows 2 lone pairs, 1 bond pair. So obviously oxygen having a 6 valence electrons, 2 lone pairs, 2 unpairs, the 2 unpairs participating in a chemical bond. But here 2 lone pairs are there, 1 unpair participated with the hydrogen, that is 1 bond pair, 2, 4, 6, and here we have a 1 unpair electron, that is called a free radical, that is called free radicals. This is a common classification of a cation, anion and a free radical. In which reactions we observe this cation fragment and anion fragment? Mostly in ionic compounds. Mostly in ionic compounds, example salts, Na plus Cl minus. So Na exists as a positive fragment, Cl exists as a negative fragment. By their electrostatic forces, they are become close, exist as a crystal lattice called a common salt, called a common salt. So here I am taking some reactions which gives positive fragment, negative fragment, as well free radical, as well free radical. So may I remove this? So mostly salts, here NaCl. So that salt decompose, as obviously when we are taking into solubility, these are get converted into ions, that is Na plus Cl minus KMnO4, potassium permanganate. What about this potassium permanganate? Get decomposed into K plus MnO4 minus. Example here I am taking a FeSO4, ferrous sulfate. Ferrous exists as plus 2, SO4 minus 2. You just remember blindly, SO4, it's minus 2. So whatever the cation is coming before this should be plus 2. Whether minus plus 1, plus 1, 2, or only one fragment with a plus 2, like a Fe plus 2. You can take a zinc sulfate, that is SO4 minus 2 is common. That is a polyatomic anion. So what about zinc? Should be plus 2. Should be plus 2. Here I am taking a Na2SO4. So we are taking a 2 sodium atoms, which gives plus 1 oxidation state. Plus 1, plus 1, plus 2. That is neutralized by SO4 minus 2. SO4 minus 2. Like here MgCl2. So magnesium with a plus 2 charge, each chlorine gives minus 1 oxidation state. So here 2 Cl minus. H3PO4, which is a covalent, gives a acid, that means a protons, H plus, 3H plus, plus PO4 minus 3, PO4 minus 3. HCl then decompose into H plus Cl minus, and here we have other organic compounds like alcohol, oxygen to hydrogen bond get cleaved heterolytically, then we will get a O minus H plus. That means hydrogen lost electron, oxygen gained electron. So hydrogen given electron to the oxygen, then oxygen got minus one charge, hydrogen got a plus one charge. Like we have organic molecules also which gives like here C carboxylic acid which decompose into carboxylate O minus plus H plus. So these are some examples which giving a cation as well anion, cation as well anion. So coming to free radical, free radicals which are mostly covalent compounds, that is organic compounds on homolytic cleavage, on homolytic cleavage, see here Br bonded to Br cleave homolytically, sorry, cleave homolytically, then we will get a radicals, we will get a radicals. So here to understand what is heterolytic cleavage, what is homolytic cleavage, we have another video, you just do watch that video, then it's become very easy. So Br2 on homolytic cleavage we are getting a Br radical, Br radical. Example here HCl on homolytic cleavage we will get a H radical, Cl radical. Here CH3 bonded to CH3 on homolytic cleavage we will get a CH3 radical plus CH3 radical, CH3 radical plus CH3 radical. So free radicals generate on a homolytic cleavage of covalent compounds, covalent compounds. What about cation and anion? Mostly salts which are inorganic compounds, on decomposition they give positive ion, negative ion, cation and anion. Also other organic compounds which having a functional part, which having a functional part, then they are decomposing, that means participating in a bond cleavage, that is heterolytic cleavage, we are getting a negative fragment, a positive fragment. So I hope you understand well what is cation, what is anion and what is free radical. So if you like the video, subscribe the channel, share, like, comment and hit the bell icon so that you will get latest video lectures. Thank you.